Hello everyone, today we will have obstetric lecture, that is Rh negative pregnancy. Before starting this lecture, you should know the blood group of or the physiology. Basically, we should know the blood groups. Commonly we all know that blood groups are AB positive and O positive, O negative, but there is Rh factor with this blood group, which is the determining factor for the blood groups. So because of this, there is a positive group or negative group. So you just go through all these things, because if concepts are clear, then only you understand the basic fundamentals. So Rh negative pregnancy, in this topic we will discuss about the mechanism or the obstetric complications which are arising from the negative blood group of mother. This is the disorder of mother in which there is a negative blood group. In that female, there is negative blood group, and her husband's blood group may be positive, and because of that baby's blood group may be positive. And what happens when there is negative blood group and positive blood group? There is antigen antibody reaction and the hemolysis takes place. You should know, because while doing blood transfusion, we check the blood groups. Why? Because to avoid these complications of hemolysis. So for obstetric purpose, if the female is negative blood group and husband's blood group is positive, or if baby's blood group is positive, these complications will take place. So Rh negative pregnancy, in this topic we will see the blood group of mother, how it affects on the baby. This is the disorder, or this is the blood group which is affecting on the baby. It is complication of that fetus, but it is because of negative blood group of mother. So Rh negative pregnancy, this is the abnormal thing which is usually seen after first delivery, first abortion, or after any first obstetric process. Why it is seen? Because first obstetric process, because the first baby which is having the blood group may be positive, and because of this fetal maternal hemorrhage, which is usually occurs after the first delivery, after first cesarean, after first abortion. So this takes place in that maternal circulation, and there are antibodies form in the maternal circulation, and these antibodies will affect the next pregnancy or next baby's hemolysis will takes place in next pregnancy. So there will be complication in her next pregnancy. So clear this fundament that in Rh negative pregnancy female, first pregnancy is usually not expected any complication in that pregnancy. There are no complications, but chances of fetal complications are seen on the next pregnancy, or on the second pregnancy or onward pregnancy. So Rh negative pregnancy, in this condition there is negative blood group of mother. There is mixing of this blood group of mother and fetus, usually in the process of normal delivery, cesarean section, MTP, amniocentesis, or any surgical procedure during obstetric. This can called fetomaternal hemorrhage, that is mixing of fetal and maternal blood, and that will complicate the things in the next pregnancy. So because of this fetomaternal hemorrhage, there is hemolysis of the fetus, and because of this there is secretion of, or there is increased level of bilirubin in that baby. Bilirubin level is increased in that fetus, and there is decreased level of hemoglobin. You should clearly know the cycle, hem and globin and bilirubin formation, all these things you should know, because in this there is hemolysis which takes place, and because of excessive hemolysis there is destruction of red blood cells or RBCs, and because of excessive destruction there is excessive production of bilirubin, and there is decreased level of hemoglobin. So baby will be anemic, baby will be jaundiced. Because of increased level of bilirubin there is jaundice. You should know the diseases now. These are the common diseases: jaundice, anemia. And why it takes place? Because of increased level of bilirubin there is jaundice, because of decreased level of hemoglobin there will be anemia. So these are the fetal complications which are takes place because of negative blood group of mother. So complications of this negative pregnancy, fetal complications are, they are divided in three categories: mild, moderate and severe. So mild complication is hemolytic anemia. Like we had discussed, there is hemolysis in the fetal circulation, and because of this there is increased level of bilirubin, decreased level of hemoglobin. So there is hemolytic anemia, but this is mild degree and baby will have low HP. But there is yellowish discoloration of skin of baby. Baby is jaundiced. It is not born with jaundice, but baby becomes yellow colored within few hours of delivery. Newborn baby is usually pinkish color, but when it turns to be yellowish, that is neonatal jaundice. Physiological neonatal jaundice is very common. That means neonatal jaundice, usually all the babies have this type of jaundice, but it disappears within few days of delivery. But if it is pathological jaundice, like in hemolytic anemia and all those things, there is increased level of this yellowish discoloration on baby, and it does not disappear after some days or after few days of delivery. In fact, it is increasing day by day. So it is hemolytic anemia. There is destruction of RBC, and because of increased level of bilirubin, there is yellowish discoloration of skin. Baby's urine color is yellow. Amniotic fluid is yellow. When it is born, the fluid color is yellow. Umbilical cord is yellow color, and baby have slight enlargement of liver and spleen. So that is hemolytic anemia. Moderate complication is usually there is icterus gravis neonatorum. This moderate complication is called as icterus gravis neonatorum. In this also baby becomes jaundiced after some hours of delivery, and there is yellowish discoloration, stool and urine, all the things are yellow colored. Amniotic fluid is dark yellow colored. This umbilical cord stains yellow. Baby's sclera and all the things are yellow colored. Baby have high pitch cry, and this usually does not disappear. This jaundice does not disappear after a week also after delivery, and in fact it is increasing after some days. And baby's growth is slightly decreased or retarded growth is seen in moderate complication. And next is severe complication. In severe complication, it is called as hydrops fetalis. In this complication, as it is a serious thing, there is severe destruction of RBCs. Patient baby is severely anemic, very jaundiced, totally yellow colored, and there is enlargement of liver and spleen. In mild, there is slight enlargement. In moderate, there is enlargement of liver and spleen, but in severe, liver and spleen are enlarged. There is totally ascites developed, hydrothorax is developed, and baby have high pitch cry. Sometimes baby show the convulsions because of hypoxia to that baby. Baby have the convulsions, that is called as kernicterus. That is baby's neck is retracted. Baby have the convulsive attacks, and that is called as kernicterus, which are the early convulsions which are seen in the severe complication of Rh negative pregnancy. And baby is hydrops fetalis. There is ascites, hydrothorax, and all the yellow colored things are seen. Baby's color is yellow, sclera is yellow, amniotic fluid is dark yellow, umbilical cord is yellow, and this jaundice is increasing day by day. After a few hours of delivery, this jaundice starts to increase. So this is the severe complication. Usually prognosis is good at the mild grade. Moderate grade is also okay, but for severe grade, baby's prognosis is not good. Usually it leads to death of baby. So these are the complications, fetal complications, which are seen because of Rh negative pregnancy. This is a simple thing to understand. This is because of her negative blood group, which is usually negative blood group is common for her. But because of fetomaternal hemorrhage, or because of history of previous pregnancy, previous abortion, or previous any surgical procedure, obstetric surgical procedure, where there is involvement or formation of a baby which have positive blood group. That means mixing of positive and negative blood group, which forms the antibodies in her circulation, in maternal circulation, that will destruct the fetal circulation in next pregnancy. So after destruction of the RBCs, what complication will happen? We all had seen, that is mild, moderate, severe. In mild, there is hemolytic anemia. For moderate, there is icterus gravis neonatorum, and severe is hydrops fetalis with kernicterus. So these are the fetal complications. Investigation we do, basic investigation is blood grouping of mother as well as husband. And along with that, we do the indirect Coombs test. this indirect home test is also their serological test, which is done. You have come across this test in pathology, second year pathology. Just go through it, indirect home test. Serological test which we perform for the Rh negative pregnancy. Next investigation, we do the amniocentesis. That is, we take the amniotic fluid. Under the USG guidance, we take the amniotic fluid from the plastic syringe, and the site is located, where is the placenta, where is the baby, where is the amniotic fluid, and after proper USG guidance, we take out the amniotic fluid and we study this amniotic fluid for the level of bilirubin. So amniocentesis, spectrophotometry is the test which we do for the level of bilirubin in baby. So all these things we do for the investigative part. That is routine blood grouping and indirect home test and spectrophotometry, amniocentesis. These are the tests for Rh negative pregnancy. Treatment is after the birth of baby, depending on the grade of complication, pediatric care is advised. For a mild complication, usually neonatal care is given. For the jaundice treatment, what medicines and multivitamin drops, antibiotic drops and phototherapy, all things are given. For moderate to severe, neonatal ICU care is indicated. But to prevent this complication, to prevent all these things, we give the treatment for mother, that is injection NTD, which is given at the 7th month or 28 weeks of pregnancy, which is the vaccination for the avoidance of this complication. We give injection NTD intramuscularly, we give on the 28 weeks or 7th month of pregnancy, and also it is given within 72 hours of delivery. On her first delivery, first abortion, first whatever obstetric procedure we perform, we give this injection within 72 hours. Why it is given? Because to avoid this antigen antibody formation in her circulation. So we give this NTD injection immediately after any procedure for Rh negative mother. And also during her pregnancy, during her ANC, we give this injection on 7th month, that is 28 weeks. So that is about Rh negative pregnancy. This is the disorder of mother, or this is the negative blood group of mother, not exactly the disorder, but it is the abnormal blood group of mother that complicates the fetal things, and which are because of fetomaternal hemorrhage. There is antigen antibody formation. This antibody in her circulation that cause complication for the fetus, and the complications are seen, that is anemia, jaundice and severe jaundice with convulsion leading to fetal death. So to avoid these things, we give the some vaccination in the form of NTD injection, particularly within 72 hours of any procedure or during the ANC at 7th month.